Hey fellow travelers, welcome to our channel. If you're looking for top tourist destinations, then Santa Barbara is for you. In today's video, together we will explore the top 10 things to do in Santa Barbara. Before we get into the video, make sure to check out the link in the description for the best way to book a flight at the cheapest price possible. Now let's explore. Number 10, Stern's Wharf. Looking for a restaurant with views? Stern Wharf, located next to the harbor, offers plenty of diversions such as restaurants, a shellfish market, shops, educational facilities, and many more from where you can enjoy the breathtaking views of the harbor and beaches along with a seafood lunch. A backdrop of the Santa Ana's mountains provides an even more vivid scenario to the entire wharf. Situated at the end of the popular State Street and home to more than 17 businesses, the wharf is one of the most visited places in Santa Barbara where visitors have the option of taking cruises and water taxis from the wharf, or they can go for a walk and sample some of their famous ice creams. To explore the area around the Stern's Wharf through your own way, just rent a bike from one of the nearby rental shops and pedal along the Cabrillo bike path to do some sightseeing of this scenic beachfront and stay fit at the same time. Number 9. Santa Barbara County Courthouse. Most of you will disagree with the idea of visiting a courthouse while on vacation as you think it is really dry and boring, right? Wrong. Completed in 1929, the Santa Barbara County Courthouse is a beautiful Spanish Moorish palace surrounded by lawns and sunken tropical gardens and is one of the architectural jewels of the city. The complex impresses visitors with its intricate tile mosaics, colorful gardens, and jaw-dropping view of the city and ocean below, due to which it hosts many public and private functions such as community events and weddings throughout the year. Paying a visit to this eye-catching landmark, which occupies a full city block, is among the top things to do in Santa Barbara, California, which allows you to enjoy beautiful views of the city from the clock tower. It's a fully functional courthouse where lawyers and judges provide judicial service, along with 360-degree views of the city, the ocean, and the mountains. Number 8. Santa Barbara Beaches. If you're looking for the best pockets of sand for sunbathing and some enjoyment, you're in luck. All of four Santa Barbara's beautiful beaches, Leadbitter, Arroyo Burro, West, and East, offers stunning scenery, soft sand, and almost year-round sunshine. Santa Barbara beaches are among the best beaches in Southern California. While Arroyo Burro is best for travelers with kids and dogs as it offers gentle surf and a fantastic beachfront restaurant, Leadbitter has the harbor, and East Beach and West Beach are tourist favorites as stretching in either direction from Stern's Wharf, these two beaches capture the classic and ideal image of the California coast. Backed by the Santa Ana's Mountains and shielded by the Channel Islands offshore, the south-facing coastline offers the perfect combination of sand and sea for each and every type of beach lover. Number 7. Santa Barbara Zoo. Santa Barbara Zoo, one of the top and fun things to do in Santa Barbara, especially with kids, provides open, naturalistic habitats to over 500 animals from 146 different species of mammals, birds, reptiles, and even insects. Spanning over only across 30 acres, it is one of America's greatest small zoo, having impressive variety of animals including leopards, gorillas, penguin, and many more. Its compound is composed of large, open spaces and lush gardens of rare exotic plants, which impart the feel of a botanical garden, making it a lovely place to stroll around. It hosts monthly multidisciplinary hands-on activities for kids as well as fun family events year-round, including Boo at the Zoo and Sleepover Sapphires. The kids can also engage in interactive experiences, such as little ones can feed the animals at the barnyard. Be a zookeeper for a day. Would you enjoy it? Well, I will. Number 6. Whale watching tours. Santa Barbara Channel's nutrient-rich water feeding over 27 different species of dolphins, whales, and marine life makes it one of the best places in the country to view marine mammals in the wild. Santa Barbara provides a fantastic spot to enjoy whale watching, such as a humpback whale breach from the ocean. The types of marine mammals that you can spot depend largely on the season in Santa Barbara. From late spring through early fall, there are regular sightings of humpback whales and blue whales, and during the standard southern and northern immigration types, gray whales starts appearing. Even if you aren't lucky enough to spot any whales, you can usually see other marine animals such as sea lions, dolphins, and orcas. Number 5. Santa Barbara Museum of Art. This museum of art is located in the heart of downtown on bustling State Street, holds an impressive collection of art, and infuses some high culture in this small city. Found in 1941, it's home to more than 27,000 works of art, and it also hosts superb traveling exhibitions and features a children's gallery with fun interactive displays. Originally the Santa Barbara Post Office, the building was renovated and now contains 60,000 square feet for not only art exhibits, but also for an auditorium, a library, a museum store, and a cafe where after your visit you can enjoy a snack. Due to the museum's commitment to education, you can watch performances, attend lectures and seminars, and go on guided tours. If you are in Santa Barbara, you should check this place. Number 4. Santa Barbara Maritime Museum. Do you like fishing and diving? The Santa Barbara Maritime Museum, located on Harbor Way, is a unique and fun must-see spot which is dedicated to preserving and paying homage to the city's rich maritime history by the use of artifacts, exhibits, and even events. The museum also offers educational opportunities activities for children and adults, allowing them to learn about local maritime history and making them learn valuable skills such as teamwork and problem-solving skills. This sea-themed museum is particularly fun for children with scavenger hunts, a working periscope, and other interactive exhibits, and you can see all sorts of equipment here. Photographers can snap some beautiful photos of the harbor and city from the top floor viewing deck. Not only photographers, if you are willing to pay a visit here, you can also click some amazing photographs. Number 3. Santa Barbara Botanic Garden. Are you a nature lover? Have you ever feel craving of a dose of nature? If yes, then Santa Botanic Garden, 78 acres of lush green with beautiful and stunning views of the mountains and ocean awaits you. The gardens showcase more than 1,000 species of native and extremely rare California plants and trees. The feature which differentiates it from other botanical parks is that it protects plants unique to Central California's coastal region, indifferent to their individual identity. Highlights of the garden include the historic Mission Dam and aqueduct built in 1807, Wildflower Meadow, a lovely Japanese tea house and tea garden, and a redwood grove. In all, there are almost 6 miles of paths to explore and more than 1,000 types of plants, and apart from lavish green, the visitors can enjoy other available facilities also, such as herbarium, a library, and a retail nursery. You can either take a guided tour or can just wander on your own. Number 2. El Presidio de Santa Barbara State Historic Site. Take a step back in time with a visit to El Presidio de Santa Barbara, one of the most striking slices of history in Santa Barbara. Originally built in 1782 by Spaniards, it has changed over years, and now the park is home to 17 buildings and sites built around a quadrangle known as the Plaza de Armas. Near these many marvelous spots in El Presidio, you can also find a two-story observation tower and a beautiful heritage garden with plants like prickly pear and grapes. If you visit here, you can learn about the Chumash Native Americans and the Spanish colonization of the land and interesting tidbits about the building. Number 1. Lotusland. Lotusland, a beautiful and magnificent exotic garden located on the private property of famous Polish opera singer Madame Ganowalska, who transformed her 37-acre estate into a garden wonderland by collecting spectacular exotic plants during her life. The gorgeous, rare, and often unusual plants that you will find in Lotusland shows the capricious tone of the garden, reflecting a taste of the flair and personality of Madame Walska herself. Highlights are the Blue Garden, Palm Garden, Japanese Garden, and the Theater Garden, with a collection of antique stone figures from France. Upon her death in 1984, Lotusland became a non-profit public botanical garden which opened it to the public in 1993, and its exceptional educational programs continue to benefit the local community. If you are looking for things to do in Santa Barbara for garden lovers, this is a must-see attraction. Take a walk around Lotusland and you will be taken aback by this magical, breathtakingly beautiful place and will feel the spirit of one exceptional woman. Clearly, Santa Barbara is one of the most glamorous towns in California, and with so many Santa Barbara attractions and numerous places to visit brimming with exciting activities, it can be difficult to figure out what to do while you're in this location. Which place would you like to visit among all of these? Feel free to share your experiences if you have ever visited there, and yeah, feel to like this video and to subscribe to our channel to know more about such fascinating places. That's all for today.